compete. Take your L like a boss, stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss, I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck, I had a dream in the store. Living my life cause we up, looking back like where the love. That's why I be hella low key, but contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets, struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash, but baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming against all.
Tonight, it's Madden NFL football. Super Bowl 57.
Presented by EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion New England Patriots taking on the NFC champions, the New Orleans Saints. Changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. On this series after the delay of game, first and 15. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of two.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude. And well, I'm not going to ask the cliche what's going through his mind right now, but maybe the better question, CD, what do you think of the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon. He had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handled winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things. And then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. With the first touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
That this is the biggest moment for any one of these players in their professional career. Nothing else compares to the Super Bowl.
And there's no question about it. You're right. Nothing else compares to the Super Bowl. I will say it's impossible that we might see a bit of a letdown for such an emotionally charged win in the conference championship. Getting to the big game with a win over your most bitter rival is a Super Bowl caliber win for that team. Now they've got to regroup.
Goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Avery Williamson. He brought the pressure on the blitz, and he gets there for a loss of 12. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A nice little gain. It'll be a pickup of 8 on the screen, and it sets up a third down. We'll see a lot of that from Drew Brees. Spread the field, get rid of the ball quickly.
He spreads the field out a lot, so he's able to recognize the defenses, the coverages, and if people are going to blitz him. And he has the fortitude to stand in there when they do. He serves as his own blitz control, so to speak. Hey, you got a free runner coming, that's one less guy in coverage. He'll stand in there, take the hit, and deliver a strike down the field.
Able to convert on 3rd and 14, a terrific play call.
I know this made me jump in the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get advantage that way.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 38. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. He's going to be caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Last play, they went over 20 yards. This time, they top 30.
Well, after the standard two-week layoff, you always wonder, how's your offense going to respond and come out and play here in the Super Bowl? Well, they got a great answer right there, and almost a sigh of relief on that side of the field, because now they've got to feel like they can use their entire playbook and game plan for this one.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. Going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage.
Another carry.
They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
A big one here early in this Super Bowl. It's 3rd and goal.
From the gun, it's Breeze. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line.
Talk about how teams are so competitively matched and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
Man, you know he hated taking the loss there on third down.
Makes the score Saints 10, Patriots 7.
Schedule, stand ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it. 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Oh, nice spin. And they'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And a give this time to the tailback. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Breeze going to try and throw on third down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 30. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Into the red zone. It's Breeze. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. His 2nd touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Saints have moved out in front. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to...
Give. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Nice
nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Whoosh! Midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then? You take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. A spin, and he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles where he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line. And that's McCoy, who is still down following the play. Appears shaken up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The Saints on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4. Shotgun now for Breeze. There's that man again. It's complete. And he's going to have a Saints first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and 5. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Bud Dupree just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both of these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Able to convert on 3rd and 14, a terrific play call.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else, end up going to the running back out of the backfield, and he picks up a back-breaking first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 15, it's 1st and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he is into the end zone, touchdown New Orleans. A great play there with his 3rd touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Saints have moved out in front. He's got the hat trick, 3 touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours?
I didn't have mine. You've got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is good.
This offense gets ready to take over. On first down, Breeze. Right, and that's complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Breeze now. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Now it looks like we're going to time out as there's a Saints player down here on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. To throw, it's Breeze. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. With a record fourth Super Bowl touchdown tonight. And the Saints add on to their lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half.
Set for the next drive. On first down, Meeks. And he'll get this one off to about his 14. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
There defensively was Nasir Adderley making a nice play.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched him move for move and knocked it away.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Nice third down conversion at even 20 yards.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Run got three. Now here's second and 7. There's Breeze. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 22 yards on the catch and run. A first down.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 41. Flushed out right. He'll try and run it. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
And 5 at the 36-yard line.
To throw again on second down. Breeze. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Oh, now he bowls it. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose.
Is not free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like it's almost like baseball. baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get it wrong, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover.
It goes as a gain of 9, and it moves the chains.
Brandon, a lot of times you'll see running backs rotate in and out of the game, whether it's a completed pass, a good run, it doesn't matter. Here, not only does he stay in, but they go right back to it, and he makes another nice play, back-to-back catches.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Breeze. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
Would take it in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not a...
This offense gets set to take over.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Quick slant, going to be complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. position thanks to the interception. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where there'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Give them 14 on that one and a first down.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
He's tackled at the 29.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, cut their spot, and stacked him up.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the one.
To me, that's a terrific run on first and goal at the 3. They got 2 yards. I'd line right back up and give it to him again.
On second and goal, they'll give it to him again. And this time, he is in.
Yes.
Punching it in from a yard away. And the Saints now at 6 to their lead. How about the... This offense gets set to take over. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28.
A 3-yard pickup brings up.
Now Breeze. Space to maneuver at the 40. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete.
Another nice pick up through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's got this down to the 35. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Brandon, every great running backs coach I've talked with has always talked about when you have great vision, you're not consciously thinking about your cuts and your moves. You're just doing them. And I think that's what we're seeing tonight. He's about run them into submission, hasn't he?
You took the words right out of my mouth. I was just going to use that phrase. He has run them into submission.
Wave the white flag.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 35-yard line. And a gain of 3 to the 33.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Maybe a frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. They'll try the left side. Middleton. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage.
Number 20.
No gain on the play there. 2nd down. No, no doubt here in the fourth quarter, this is a huge defensive series.
Hey, they can read the scoreboard. They realize if they give up a field goal here, this game might be out of reach. They understand the stakes and are playing accordingly.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. The Saints on third down. Six conversions and nine tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This is third and four. Eluding the pressure. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Second. Gets set to take over. They'll run on first down. Middleton. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard.
Definitely too early to panic, but that is his fourth carry of the game, and collectively has a total 10 yards. So maybe there's no panic, but maybe some concern.
Yeah, and maybe a little concern up front because they're not giving him any space right now. On second and nine, Breeze. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
On first down, Middleton. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Through, and he gets this all the way down to the Patriots' 31-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Patriot down, slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter. Looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips. They're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys, they're just saying, let's just keep running it out. We got them now.
They'll keep it on the ground. Middleton, and he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's third and 2. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes the defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. That is likely the final play of this game, and no better feeling, I would imagine, than taking a knee to wrap up the Super Bowl.
Culminates everything. The championship is theirs. And just think, the last play they had in practice before this game began was doing this, practicing taking a knee and winning a Super Bowl.
And they get to do just that. And the Lombardi Trophy is headed back to the Bayou. The New Orleans Saints, Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. And what a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.